Ah yes, another week, another Overkill Reviews, another Blaine Smith. That's right, it's Blaine Smith with Overkill Reviews, Banger's weekly metal review show. Hey, as always, if you like me, twitch.tv/metalcomedy, you've heard it a million times. And if you like us, Patreon, there's some cool stuff coming up that's gonna be on there. Whatever. Go check it out. Hey, nice, thanks. But we got music for you. It's not, I understand, it's not the music that you think it should be today. It's because they were weird about the album and they really tried to keep it from leaking. And as far as I can tell, complete success. Not giving any copies to the press totally prevented your album from leaking. But yes, the Tool review will be up on Tuesday. Until then, we got this. Yes, of course, I am not fit to review Tool. Entombed AD, that's my wheelhouse, because they released Bowels of Earth on Century Media today, and I'm gonna talk about it. Nice. So this is one of those real metal band bios. Even if you didn't know Entombed, which you probably do, and you didn't know AD, which you also probably do, you could guess it was a metal band from this situation. So Entombed AD is one of those AD added on for maybe legal reasons, maybe just to be considerate so we don't get confused. Maybe they're not, it's a confusing situation. Basically, Entombed vocalist LG Petrov was like, hey man, I want to make new tunes. And then Entombed guitarist Alex Hilliard was like, hey man, I want, and we don't know what he wants because the last Entombed album came out in 2007. Shrug. So what LG did was like, hey, me and some of the guys that are currently in Entombed are just going to go over here and record Entombed songs and just slap an AD on the end. Cool? And I don't know if it's cool. It might not be cool between them, but what are you gonna do? He clearly wanted to make music because Entombed AD has been around for 5 years and this is their third album. Hey, there's a pace that he wanted to be setting. Nothing really of note except Guilherme Miranda joins on guitar out of Brazil. So hey, a little bit of a shakeup. So we're getting more Entombed, but should we? Hey, we're gonna find out in a review. So we open up on the album and we get the Swedishiest riff that ever Swedened. Yeah, it opens up how you'd expect. This is an Entombed AD record and it sounds suitably Entombed-y. You know, the past two records have been not bad, but you know, a little one note. And it starts off on a similar vibe. Everything sounds the way you'd expect, although the death and roll vibe gives everything a bit of a color of sounding a little bit like High on Fire. So that's nice. That's another great band, and I'm sure both bands would be happy being talked about together. But there was a little surprise towards the end of the fourth track, Bowels of Earth, the title track. There's a more like a heavy metal style solo that I was like, oh, cool, nice. And then that wasn't the only rumble strip keeping your eyes on the road late at night. So spacing out what I affectionately call B-tier Entombed tracks is definitely some way more death and roll than maybe ever before in Entombed slash Entombed AD history. They're going with that, and I think it's a good decision because you get Bourbon Nightmare halfway through the record, which starts a little mariachi band action. And I know sometimes I say, what the hell was that Spanish guitar intro to mean someone doing some weird clean noodling, but I literally mean a mariachi band opens this thing up. And then you get some cool overdrive guitar on the chorus, you get a real rad solo towards the end, and the middle builds to this like cacophony nonsense that sounds like a Bourbon Nightmare. Well named. We also get an unexpected Hank Williams cover towards the end in I'll Never Get Out of This World Alive, which adds some real fun to what's going on, which is a good decision. You know, having Entombed growl out, my fishing pole's broke, the creek is full of sand, my woman went away with another man, is just puts a smile on your face. 50s lyrics like that coming barked out of LG is a great, great pairing, and like I said. Nice bit of air in the record. Nice to break things up. They even took a swing at some atmosphere with the closing track being a slower build that leads into some, at the very end, some nice soaring guitars that, it's a good progression. It's nice. It's a little journey at the end. It caps the album off well. Good job. Maybe the smartest decision this time around, though, for AD, is that this is the shortest record they've put out by a good margin, coming in at a svelte 36 pounds, 17 ounces, and a third of that being made up by the kind of weirder tracks I was just talking about. You get a more concise, to the point, Entombed record. Trim and entertaining, without a lot going on upstairs, why it's the Blaine of Entombed records. So, what's bad? Well, I think we can all agree having the word Entombed stamped on a record is a pretty heavy thing to get over. It's a band that has released at least one Bulletproof Legend by almost everybody's standards, whether you're a fan or not. So that's gonna be a heavy specter hanging over any record that bears that name. And despite the fact that Ominous Specters looming over is a great cover for a metal album, it's not necessarily the best vibe for a metal album. So, do they overcome the previous things of the past? No, they don't. They absolutely do not. This is not gonna be better than Left Hand Path. That's not gonna happen. But this time out, it seems like maybe the bands have fully acknowledged that that's not gonna happen and are finally kind of free of that baggage. You know, it might be a little unfair to expect them to do that. You can't pioneer forever. I mean, at some point, you gotta just soak up what you've done. I mean, George Washington didn't invent America and laser guns, just laser guns. So what it does seem like AD has figured out how to do this time around is just sidestep that responsibility altogether, which is another great Blaine trait, sidestepping responsibilities. Instead of competing with themselves, they're just taking a victory lap. They're enjoying it. They're soaking it up. This is what Entombed sounds like. This is what a lot of people liked it to sound like. So, hey, here's a party Entombed record. Put this Entombed record on a kegger. Have fun. I love when bands I love put out a record that serves a purpose that was unfilled in their catalog. What this is you left one of your Entombed records out, someone spilled a beer on it, and instead of ruining the thing, hey, it made it a fun time. It's a silly record. It's a good time. Put it on. And hey, put it on for someone that maybe isn't a fan of Entombed. I think this could be a good record to help bring more people into the fold. Because although they're an absolute legend and classic in the scene, they're not one of the bigger recognized death metal bands like, say, Cannibal Corpse or Morbid Angel and stuff. It's definitely a little more on the cult side. Obviously not a huge amount on the cult side, but it's still, it's more under there. And this could be a good way to kind of ensure that Entombed gets the love it deserves by having more people go, yeah, that's cool. All right, give me something a little harder, you know? You gotta ease people into the pool. All I can say is, give me a tour with AD, Midnight, and Cannibal Corpse, and that's probably the most fun anyone's gonna have to show all year. And that's why I'm giving this 4 out of 5 skulls that are having a bourbon nightmare. And thus brings us to shoutouts time.
Woo, shoutouts.
So the first shoutout is totally in the opposite direction. It's Orm IR, whatever, on Interdisciplinarian. Yeah, there we go. It's a band from Denmark. They released 24-minute songs that's black metal, epic, buildy, nonsense is stuff I really enjoy as well. So once the party's done and you're trying to go to bed, that's a good record to put on. Relax, enjoy yourself, soak up some 24-minute track black metal madness. And also, Sempiternal Dusk is releasing Cenotaph of Defectuous Creation on Dark Descent Records. This is great death doom on the heavier, more scary side, and not on the like listful longing side. It's, you know, the death doom that's my favorite. And hey, just a quick shout out to Testimony Records. Thanks for sending me a copy of Carnal Tomb. You might remember Carnal Tomb from my Metal Monthly. This is still really great. Still one of the coolest death metal albums to release this year. So hey, check it out. You can get it on vinyl. So that's been the review. Once again, a reminder for angry YouTube commenters, the Tool record review will be on Tuesday. Take a breath. You waited 13 years. What's a couple more days?